प्रतिभा मैम, यू कैन स्टार्ट योर लेक्चर।
यस सर, थैंक यू। वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून वंस अगेन डियर स्टूडेंट्स। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी आर फोकस्ड ऑन द की कंसेप्ट ऑफ द टाइटल ऑफ द कोर्स 201। नाउ हु विल टेल मी टाइटल ऑफ द कोर्स? Just recall name of the paper. Please type title of the course in the chat box. You don't you remember?
Hello.
Yes, hello.
Swapnali here.
Yes, Swapnali.
Quality and management in school education.
Quality and management. Let me correct you. Quality and management of school education. Yes, Meenal, very nice. Okay. It is quality and management of education. And in that lecture, we focused on the key concept, that is quality management in the context of school education. Okay. And we discussed also various objective of this course, that is 201. Now let me move ahead and we'll see entire syllabus of course 201. Now I'm going to share screen. Is it visible to all? If it is visible, then please type yes in the chat box. Yes. Please mute your audio so that other will not get disturbed. You can use short forms also. Just instead of yes, you can just write why. Okay. See, in the last lecture, we have discussed about VET course code 201. The title was Quality and Management of School Education. And we discussed very deeply all objectives of the course. Now, I'm going to show you actual syllabus of course 201. Total 4 units are there in 201. I'm just going to show unit number 1. See, just look at once in the unit number 1. The title of the unit is Fundamentals of Management and Quality Management. In that, meanings and functions of management, types of management, modern theories of management, concept of quality management and SWOT analysis, total quality management in education, and school accreditation, meaning need criteria for school accreditation. I'm now going to stop this sharing. Now we'll share you some another screen. Just recall unit number 1, just I showed you, and compare that unit number 1 with this one. See, I showed you the syllabus given by Savitribai Phule Pune University, but here you can see the things included in the each subunit. In the previous sharing, you saw only the main points. For example, in unit number 1.1, that was meaning and functions of management. But student, they are not getting idea actually what to study under the particular subunit. So here you have to study about the concept, meaning, definitions of management, need and importance of management, and functions of management. Okay. As I told you in the previous lecture, management, this is very nearer concept of our day-to-day life. Okay. As a woman, as a mother, as a daughter-in-law, we have to do various tasks. So this is the very nearer concept of our day-to-day life. Can you see, I request any one of you Please unmute your audio and tell me about your daily schedule. How you can manage various things at a time in your house or even outside. Who is ready to share his or her experience? Yes. I want responses from your side also. Please unmute yourself and share your experience. Do you really think that this management concept is related, very much related to our life? Yes. Make daily schedule for all work. So Sheetal is saying, make daily schedule for all. Can you give me one example? Suppose in the morning, we have to do multitask, right? You have to prepare food for our family. We have to look after our kids. We have to look after elder ones in the family. So how we can manage each and everything in the house? Of course, for that, we have to plan something. For example, suppose proper planning of activities. Rupali, please unmute yourself and tell me the example how you are managing all the things in your house. Rupali?
Yes, ma'am.
Just give me example how you can manage each and everything in your house.
Ma'am, I will make a proper schedule of it that during a particular time, I will make a proper schedule of which work will be done first.
Okay. See, the sequence is there. And sequence is given on the basis of priority. Right?
Yes.
Okay. See, even for preparing food, we are planning one day before. Even at the previous night, we are planning. Right? Kaun si sabji banani hai, kya banana hai, kya karna hai. We plan each and everything before. Means, planning should be before the implementation. Right?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, Sheetal. See, concept and meaning of manage. Concept, meaning and definitions of management. Okay, most of the time you are getting confused between the concept of meaning because in the final examination, the question will be, what do you mean by management? Or explain management. Such type of questions will be. Screen is not mini visible. Okay, I will stop sharing and I will share it again. Now it is visible. If it is visible, then type yes or why in the chat box. Is it visible, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay. Okay, thank you. Concept, meaning, and definitions of management. See, whenever question will ask, what do you mean by management? Means there, you have to write different definitions of management. And along with the definitions, you have to write explanation about the definitions. But in the concept, you can write other things about the management. For example, whose audio is mute, not mute? Shaurya Mishra, I'm going to mute you. Shaurya, please mute yourself. One more student is there whose name is not displayed on the participant list. 0629730D. Please mute yourself. Okay, thank you so much. Okay, Am I audible to all? Please type yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Only one.
Yes,
okay, ma'am. Okay. Thank you. Concept, meaning, and definitions of management. See, when the question will ask, like, what do you mean by management? At that time, you have to just define the term management or the concept management. But in the concept, you have to write extra things about the management. For example, management, there is a hierarchy in the management. There are different levels of management. Okay. For example, higher level managers, lower level managers, and middle level managers. You can write extra things about the management. Then need and importance of management. I'm not going to get details about this, because in the next lecture I will teach you one topic. Okay. Then the functions of management. See, there are different functions of management. For example, planning, it is a function. It is the first and basic function of management. Okay. Then the second is types of management. There are different types of management. The first is time management. See, we have to consider each type of management by taking context of school education only. Time management, what do you mean by time management? Meaning of time management, need and importance of time management. School timetable, see, because school timetable, it is the only one who reflect actual time management of the school. So how it is important and what are the types of school timetable? Okay. For example, see, school timetable, there is a common school timetable. We can say the consolidated timetable. Along with that, there is a class-wise timetable. So these are the different types of school timetable. Okay. Then the time wasters. What are the time wasters? We have to find out there are some causes and remedies of time wasters. Okay. So this is 1.1 and 1.2 of unit number 1. Then event management. Event management means what? We have to manage each and everything regarding any event. Suppose in the context of school education, we are going to manage any event. Maybe it is curricular or co-curricular event in the school. See, this concept, that is event management, this is also very nearer concept of all of us. Okay. For example, please mute yourself. Okay. See, event management. Concept, steps, essential skills required, and role of a teacher in event management. So see what they are expecting. So this is the scope is given about the event management. Just recall birthday party of your kids. Birthday party of your kids. So again, that is also event, but that is house event. Aapke ghar ka ek koi kaarya hai, jisko aap event keh sakte hai. So for that, what kind of planning you should do? That is event management. For example, excuse me. Event management, suppose birthday party is there. So how many guests they will come at home? You are even menu for the party, the cake, the flavor of the cake, the quantity of the cake. You have to decide each and everything about that particular event. That is nothing but the event management. Means this concept, it is also very near for all of us. Concept, again, there are different steps of event management, essential skills required, and role of a teacher in event management. See, you all are would-be teacher. Okay, some of you are already teachers. So as a teacher, we should be good event managers, because we have to manage, we have to plan different events at school also, in our classroom also. For example, if you are going to hold any kind of examination, for example, quiz examination, any kind of examination in your class, even any co-curricular activity, any sports in your school. So for that also, you have to manage each and everything. So that is nothing but the event management. Understood? Have you understood this concept, that is event management, so that I can move ahead?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. The next is classroom management. Okay, classroom management means what? Management of a classroom means what? See, again, as I told you earlier, again, there is a meaning and don't get confused about the concept and meaning. I'm telling you, meaning, just recall all the definitions of the particular concept, that is classroom management. And in concept, you can read extra material about the classroom management. See, most of the time, what we can see when you will visit any school, and you can see very chaos or very noise is there in the particular classroom. So what you can say, there is no classroom management. Means what? Is it true? If there is a noise or any chaos in any class, suppose there was a fifth standard class, so can you say that classroom management is not there? Yes or no?
No, ma'am. The reason can be anything.
Yes or no? No. The reason can be. Can you explain? Yes, can you explain?
If it happens, this is Meenal Upadhyay, ma'am.
Yes, Meenal, please.
Yeah. If it happens once in a time, it is okay. But if it is happening daily, then it will be make chaos, like something unusual. So,
okay. Mm. Okay, good try, Meenal. Mm. See, most of the time, what we are saying, if suppose particular class is making noise, so we are saying that teacher is not having that management skill, that is classroom management skill. But it is not true, because see, suppose teacher is teaching particular topic with the help of giving different activities. Okay, she is teaching any topic by giving different activities. So at that time, she is taking group work from the class. So maybe there are chances of noise in the classroom. So at that time, we can say there is an active learning. So that is, we cannot say that the teacher is not having classroom management. Okay. But apart from that, if there is a noise in the classroom, then we can say there is not proper classroom management. Okay. Concept, meaning, and techniques of classroom management. There are different techniques of classroom management. See, in the first year, you learn about the models of teaching. So most of the time, what happens in the classroom, we can see different learners are there. Some learners are auditory learners, some learners are visual learners, some learners are audio-visual learners. So models of teaching is one technique we can apply in the classroom teaching to avoid this dilemma that which techniques or which learning style teacher is supposed to use while teaching in the classroom. Then role of a teacher in a classroom management. See, actually the top layer manager, he is responsible for the management, but he is not that much responsible for the classroom management, because who is looking to the kids? Only the teacher, she is looking towards the kids. So here, role of a teacher is very, very important in the classroom management. Then there are different types of discipline. Discipline means what? A particular person, he is not disciplined person. Okay, jisko hum shist bolte hai. There are different types of disciplines. Then problems and remedies of discipline. Dekho, shist rehna, ye bhi ek problem ho sakta hai. Agar wo problem hai, then which type of remedies we can apply to overcome that problem, that is also important. Then next is modern theories of management. Understood classroom management? We'll learn this detail in the next lecture, next to next lecture. Okay. Am I audible? You understood?
Yes, classroom ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Modern theories of management. Now tell me, see, some students, they are from commerce background. Just raise your hand and tell me who are from commerce background. No one is there from commerce background. Yes. No one is there. Okay, Mansi, you are from commerce. Rupali. Okay. Good. See, modern theories of management. Do you know Henry Fiol, Rupali and Mansi?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, who is he?
Ma'am,
yes. Yes, Rupali, Mansi. Your voice is not audible. Yes, Mansi, Rupali, say something.
Ma'am, he has given the theory of business administration, I think.
Yes, he gives the theories of business administration. Okay. Henry Fiol's theory, we can say this theory as a Henry Fiol's theory or Fiol's theory. Or the other name is administrative management theory or administrative theory of management. See, in examination, they can ask, they can use any word, administrative theory of management, administrative management theory, or Fiol's theory of management. Okay. He gave total 5 functions and 14 principles of management, how to administer any kind of management. Then the next is Peter Drucker. See, all these are the theories. The Peter Drucker theory, it is also called as MBO, that is management by objective. See, what you have to learn. See, if you see the previous syllabus, which was given by the Pune University, only the words, that is Peter Drucker's theory, Henry Fiol's theory, only these words are given. But what exactly you're supposed to study in this, that is given here in the presentation. You have to study about the processes involved in the MBO. See, basically 3 processes are there. First is the goal setting, second is the planning, third is the participation, motivation, and control, etc. So these are the processes involved in MBO. MBO means, I'm again telling you, MBO means what? Management by objective. So this theory is called as Peter Drucker's theory or MBO theory, that is management by objective theory. Understood? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then next is concept of quality management and SWOT analysis. See, quality management, there is a merge. The quality, it is one concept. Second is management. And there is a merging of both the concept. A new concept arises, that is quality management and SWOT analysis. Have you heard this word before? SWOT
yes, analysis? Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. Means what? S?
Strength.
W? O T means what?
Strength, type. Weaknesses, opportunities, and threats.
Okay, strength, weaknesses, opportunity, and
threats.
And threats. Okay, good. Thank you. Okay, why there is a necessity of SWOT analysis? Yes. Why there is a necessity of SWOT analysis? Yes, you can give answer in one sentence or in one word. Yes, yes, your voice is not audible.
To know person's abilities. Hello.
Okay. Hello. Yes.
To know person's abilities.
To know person's abilities. See, this SWOT, strength, weakness, opportunities, and threats. So you can show the person, even the weaknesses of the person, opportunity and threat, but we can know some weaknesses of the person. So SWOT analysis will not only for the students, but it is applicable for the any organization, any institution. Okay. The SWOT analysis, it is basically for the betterment or for the development of the particular person maybe teacher, maybe student, or maybe institution, isn't it? See, so what you supposed to study in this, that is concept of quality management and SWOT analysis, meaning and definition of SWOT analysis, sorry, of quality management. What do you mean by quality management? Then SWOT analysis concept, so SWOT concept, its meaning, need and importance of SWOT, the factors, there are two factors, internal and external factors, okay? Then SWOT, it is done for the institutions, for the teachers, and for the students, okay? Can anyone tell me about the opportunities and threats? Can you give me any example? You can correlate yourself with your school, and you can give any example. Yes, who is ready to give you example? I will give chocolate to you. Not virtual chocolate, it is actual chocolate. Cadbury, you can say. SWOT, strength. See, we can do SWOT analysis of ourselves also. Suppose I'm working in that context, I can do any task of the management. I think this is my example here of my service. I'm doing here my last.
Ma'am, your voice is not clear.
Please.
Ma'am, you are not audible. Sir, I think ma'am has left the meeting.
Okay. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. My voice is audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, it's clear.
Yes.
I don't know what was the problem. Actually, I was out from the meeting. Now automatically, I get in. Okay. Screen is visible to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I was giving example regarding SWOT analysis. Suppose I'm working as a assistant professor in MIT Institute, right? So I will give you example in that context. I know my strengths. My strengths are I have leadership quality. I can do any task comfortably and effectively. I know my weakness also. I'm very instant reactor. I react immediately to anything. Opportunity, suppose this is my 10th year. So maybe after completion of the 10th year, 10th year means since 2011, I'm working with MIT. So this is my 10th year of experience. So after completion of this year, maybe I will get promotion, be a portion threat. So I will approve shows break in my so that it. So this is example of SWOT analysis. Okay, understand example. Hello? Is you are in between?
Voice is breaking, ma'am.
Hello. Am I audible to all? Hello.
Yes. Ma'am, yes, now you are audible, but while you are giving example, last two examples we couldn't hear.
Okay. Should I repeat the same example?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Just last 2 points
you can. Okay. Okay. Thank you. See, I gave example regarding the SWOT analysis. I'm going to do SWOT analysis of myself. Okay. As you all know, I'm working with MIT. Since 2011, I'm working with MIT. So in that context, I can do my SWOT analysis. So this is 10th year of my experience. Okay. So for S, that is the strength. So first I have to analyze my strengths. Just giving you one or two examples of my strength. I have leadership quality. I can do any task comfortably and effectively. So these are my strengths. Weaknesses. I'm very instant reactor. I react anything immediately. Suppose this is my weakness. I know my weakness. Then opportunity, because of this is the 10th year of my experience. Maybe next year I will get promotion. So this is the opportunity. And threats, but maybe there is a problem of university approval. So because of if I will not get this year university approval because of this pandemic situation, then it will show a break in my service. So that will be threat for me. So this is the SWOT analysis of me. Understood? SWOT analysis? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay. Thank you. The next is total quality management in education and school accreditation. So here you have to study concept, meaning, need, and importance of total quality management. See, only the keyword, only the short forms are written here. Those audios are on. Please mute your audios. See, TQM is what? Total quality management. Most of the time what happened, we are thinking about the product. Now tell me, in the school education, in the context of school education, what will be the product? Can you give me example? I'm repeating it again. In the context of school education, what will be the product?
Ma'am, students.
Yes, students. And we can say education of the student, it will be the product, right? So in the TQM, we have to think equally. See, instead of product, we have to keep our attention in the teaching learning process. So you can see you have to keep attention rather than the product on the process, that is teaching learning process. If any school, that school is applying various tools and techniques of teaching effectively in the school, the automatically the product will be outstanding, right? So here, instead of product, we have to keep our attention on the process. This is a bit information about the total quality management. See here, what you supposed to study: concept, meaning, need and importance of TQM, then the process of TQM in education, what is role of headmaster and teacher in total quality management, and the next is school accreditation, the concept of school accreditation, need, importance and criteria of school accreditation. See, as the teacher is going to assess the student, there is a criteria. So for school accreditation also, there are different criteria. The criteria can be about the admissions, about the evaluation scheme, about the actual teaching learning process, about the research work, about the extension facilities, etc. Okay, understood about this? Hello, do you understood about this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. See, just see the unit number one. It is very, very wide unit number one. Total 4 units are there in your syllabus. See, if you study this management subject, it is very easy to study, but the scope is wider and it is easy to get good marks in the final examination. Okay. See the unit. Very bigger unit. And this is a very small unit, that is unit number 2, managerial practices, human and infrastructure resources. Okay. See, resources, there are 2 types of resources: human resources and infrastructure resources. We'll see unit number 2, that is 2.1, training and development of human resources. So in this, we have to study concept, you can say process or mechanism of human resource development. Day before yesterday, you gave me example about the human resource development, so that there is a possibility of development of resources in the school or colleges. For that, person can attend various workshops, seminars, conferences, faculty development programs, etc. Then managerial quality. See, as a teacher, see, as a mother, we have to manage everything. So here, as a teacher, we have to manage everything. So teacher also have managerial qualities and skills for what? For successful human resource development. Even see here, if you are talking about the successful human resource development, so this is applicable for the manager. We can say this is applicable for the principal and headmaster, or you can say supervisor. Training and development of human resources. So training can be given pre-service and in-service. So there are 2 types of training: pre-service training and in-service training. Can anyone tell me what is difference between pre-service training and in-service training? Yes.
Ma'am, the service given before joining a job is called as pre-service, and in-service is a training given during the service.
Okay, means now you are in. Now you all are in service or pre service?
Pre service, ma'am.
Of course, you are in pre service. So, what is pre service? That is the concept. What are the objectives of pre service? Need and importance of pre service. What are the limitations of pre service? And pre service training at different levels. Different levels means what? See, we'll think only about the teachers. Okay, so pre-service training, you can see some teachers, they are teaching at the primary level, some teachers they are teaching at the secondary level, some teachers they are teaching at the college level. So there is a different kind of training is given to the teachers at the different levels. For example, suppose some teachers, they are DED, that is diploma in education, they will be primary teachers. After getting B.Ed. degree, you will be the secondary teachers. Those who have completed the M.Ed. degree, they will be the teachers at the teachers at the college level. For example, we people, the teacher educators, we have completed our masters in both in our subject as well as in the education field. So that is nothing but the pre-service teacher training program. Understood? And the in-service means what? In-service, during the service. And this is basically for the professional development of the resources or the human resources, we can say. Concept, objectives, need and importance, and types. Okay. There are different types of in-service. Different types, types means what? Just I told you, we can attend various workshops, symposiums, then conferences, faculty development programs, etc. for our professional development. That is nothing but the in-service training. Okay, understood this? Yes or no? The difference between pre-service and in-service?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
This unit is very simple and easy to study. And the second is 2.2 is role and qualities of human resources. The role of a teacher or qualities of a teacher, role of supervisor and headmaster, qualities of supervisor and headmaster, and role and qualities of parents. Okay, you can say in simply duties and responsibilities of teacher, supervisor, headmaster, and parents. Okay. I'm not going to explain this detail. Can you tell me any one quality of a teacher or of a parent? First, tell me any one quality of a teacher.
Ma'am, teacher should treat all the children equally. There should not be any bias.
So we can say no biasness. This will be the quality of a teacher. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
No biasness. Give me some more examples.
And teacher should have perfect knowledge of his or her subject.
Okay.
Like, delivering the subject.
Update knowledge. She should update knowledge. Right? Then tell me any one quality of, yes, approachable. Okay, she should be approachable. Tell me any one or two qualities of parents. She should be confident. Okay. Tell me any one quality of parent. Any one or two qualities of parents.
Yeah. A parent should understand the strength or weakness of their child.
Okay. Parents should understand strengths as well as weaknesses of their child. Some other qualities of parents or responsibilities of parents. Yes. Okay, good. Santosha, she is saying ready to accept the feedback. The feedback of whom? Feedback is given by the teacher. Feedback is given by the school. Okay, very nice, Santosha. Not Santosha, it's Sanjota. Thank you. Okay, so these are the qualities, you can say responsibilities of teacher as well as of parents. Okay, we'll move ahead. That is leadership. Leadership, the concept of leadership. So here you have to learn different definitions of leadership. Whenever leader is there, the followers are there, right? Need and styles of styles and types. See, both are not same, but here given the types, just consider only the types of leadership. Autocratic, democratic, and delegative. These only three types you have to study. In some books, they have given different other styles. Okay, this is 47 now. Okay. We have completed two units here. We'll discuss remaining two units in the next lecture. Okay. Who is having second lecture today? Who's the lecture today? I'm going to stop my screen sharing.
Darshana, ma'am.
Darshana, ma'am. She's in. Hello. I think she is not in yet. Okay. So thank you so much, student. Today we have discussed syllabus, not only the entire syllabus, only two units of the syllabus. And the remaining units we will discuss in the next lecture. Okay. So till then, Bye bye. See you. Take care.
Hello. Hello,
yes,
Mansi.
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Very good afternoon. May I audible now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay. Now my screen is visible to all.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. So once again, welcome to all. We took the orientation of this subject in the previous lecture. In that lecture, we had seen all over syllabus of 202. Also, we had seen summary of all units. We had discussed about paper pattern, mark scheme, etc. That's why you know the very well of the depth and scope of this subject. So dear student, today we will start our unit number first, that is knowledge and education. Okay, first of all, tell me you all have prepare subject wise notebook, yes or no? You have prepared subject wise notebook or notes?
No, ma'am, not yet.
Okay, if yes, then good, but no one has done it yet, then get ready early. because now the orientation of almost over for all subject. Now teaching will be start. So keep running notes. Okay. Then you don't have a book yet, and can't say when we will get it. So do all the lectures properly and keep your own notes or the screenshot of important points. Then tell me the point you want to note down. Then I will repeat it. Okay. Now we will start the unit number 4, that is knowledge and education. Okay. This first unit consists 1.1 is the data, knowledge, information, skill and wisdom. 1.2 is a source and generation of knowledge. 1.3 is a modern child-centered education, that is learning through activity. 1.4 is a modern child-centered education, learn through discovery. 1.5 is a modern child-centered education, learn through dialogues. Okay. Now we will see 1.1. We can see all concepts one by one. Okay. The first concept is data. So what is data? Then we can see the meaning of data. Facts and figure, which really something specific, but which are not organized in any way. Data is a raw information, especially facts or number collection of number collected to be examined and considered and used to help decision making. So what is the data? So dear student, data are a dynamic objective of cultural experience, having the aspects of being meaning, neutral and a dual nature of description and instruction. Then also we can say data is a mean raw information. Okay, it is a simply existence and has no significance beyond its existence. It can exist in any form, but it is does not having meaning of itself. Okay, so it is a meaning of data. We can see the next topic is the definitions of data. The first definition is data are defined as symbols that represent properties of objects, event, and their environment. This definition is getting for Akoff. The second definition is as a symbol, data is a strong of instincts, meaning a more representation. The main purpose of data is to record activity or situation to attempt to capture the true picture or real event. Evil. Okay. Also, we can say the data is given by a simple sequence of signs and symbol. Or also we can say data is understood as a stream of symbol. Okay. And the data is nothing but the sets of characters, symbols, numbers, and audiovisual bits that are represented. Okay, got it? If aapko notes lena hai, to aap is short notes aap isme nikal sakte ho. Okay. The next point is types of data. Okay. The data having a two types. A is a quantitative data and B is a qualitative data. The point A, quantitative data, consists also two factor or two point. It is a continuous data and the B is a discrete data. So we can see what is a quantitative data. Okay. Quantitative data are anything that can be expressed as a number or qualified. Okay. Quantitative data mein aapko jo bhi kuch data hai, wo aapko numeric form mein milega. Or it is expressed as a number form. Okay, for example, dimension such as the height, weight, length, or temperature and humidity, area and volume, scores on achievement test. Okay, so give me some example of quantitative data to any of you. Give me some example.
Number of the student in the class.
Very good. Next one.
Mark sheet of a student.
Very good. So it is a quantitative data. ये जो number से वो इसकी हम quantity बताते हैं, okay? And there are two types of quantitative data, which are also refers as a numerical data. Quantitative data के जो दो अलग types से, that is continuous data and discrete data. This also refers to as numerical data. Okay, so we can see the continuous data. The continuous data, as a general rule, counts are discrete and measurement are continuous. Okay, see carefully. As a general rule, counts are discrete and measurement are continuous. On the other hand, could be divided and reduce the finer and finer level. Okay, for example, of you can measure the height of your kid at progressively more precise scale, that is a meter, centimeter, millimeter. Beyond so height is a continuous data. Okay, the next is a discrete data. Next to the discrete data, if I tell you the number of apple in the box, okay, if I tell you the number of apple in the box, and that is a individual apple, okay, that the number is a piece of discrete data. So discrete data is a count that can't be made more precise. Typically it involves integers. Okay, सो डिस्क्रीट डेटा में जो नंबर्स होते हैं वो इंटीजर्स होते हैं, वो होल नंबर होते हैं. ओके, इसका हम एग्जांपल देखेंगे. द नंबर ऑफ चिल्ड्रन और अ पेट इन योर फैमिली इज अ डिस्क्रीट डेटा. अगर आपको किसी ने पूछा कि आपके घर में कितने मेंबर रहते हैं, तो आप बोल सकते कि वी हैव इन फोर मेंबर्स. ओके, बिकॉज यू आर काउंटिंग व्हाइल यू कांट हैव 2.5 kids or 1/4 kid or 3.4 kids. Okay, तो आप ऐसा तो नहीं बताते हो ना कि हमारे घर में 2.5 आदमी हम रहते हैं, ऐसा हम नहीं बता सकते. तो डिस्क्रीट डेटा में जो नंबर आते हैं वो सब इंटीजर्स होते हैं, वो सब होल नंबर होते हैं. ओके, द नेक्स्ट वन इज द सेकंड टाइप इज अ क्वालिटेटिव डेटा. ओके, the data deals with characteristics and descriptors that can't be easily measured but can be observed subjectively, such as a smell, taste, texture, or the attractiveness or a color. Okay, broadly speaking, when we measure something and give it number value, you create quantitative data. Okay, listen again. Broadly speaking, when we measure something and given it a number value, you create quantitative data. But when you classify or judge something, you create qualitative data. Okay, for example, so far, so sweet, so good. Okay, then can you tell me the some example of qualitative data? Tell me the example of qualitative data. Can I explain again qualitative data or got it? Hello.
Ma'am, this is Meenal Upadhyay.
Yes, yes.
Yes, ma'am. We can relate it with suppose as a student in a good in sports or in any other subject.
Yes.
So it can be related like qualitative data. Very suppose good. A student is good in physics or weak in maths, like
like that. Okay, okay. Very good. So आपको कंसेप्ट क्या है वो अच्छे से समझ में आए हुए तो हम नेक्स्ट कंसेप्ट की तरफ जा रहे हैं. ओके द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज अ टाइप्स ऑफ डेटा सोर्सेस. जहां से हमें डेटा मिल सकता है उस सोर्सेस के जो टाइप से वो हम यहाँ पे डिस्क्राइब करने वाले हैं. द मेजोरिटी ऑफ डेटा सोर्सेस इंक्लूडेड इन द डायरेक्टरी आर प्राइमरी डेटा सोर्सेस अल्दो सेकेंडरी डेटा सोर्सेस प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय गवर्नमेंट. ओके विच इंक्लूड substitutional addition data or analysis compared to that already published by the primary source are also included. Okay, so the first is a primary data, second is a secondary data source, and third one is a survey. So we can see primary data sources. Okay, the primary data sources that has been collect from first hand experience is known as primary data. Okay, I repeat again, data that has been collected from first hand experience is known as primary data. Okay, the primary data has not been published yet and is more reliable, authentic and objective. This type of data has not been changed or already by human beings. Therefore, its validity is greater than secondary data. Okay, जो इसकी validity है वो secondary data से बहुत ज्यादा है. Primary sources are immediate first hand accounts of a topic from people who had a direct connected with it. So primary data sources in which that responsible agencies or organization on the administrative by product or a survey data. Okay. So please tell me in short, what is a primary data sources? After that, I repeat again the primary data sources. Can I repeat again or not? Okay, Anamika Singh is here. Anamika, are you hear me? Only say yes or no. Okay, fine. Then the next part is primary data sources. Okay, text of laws and other original documents. इसमें क्या क्या इंक्लूड होता है ये हम यहाँ देखने वाले हैं. टेक्स्ट ऑफ लॉज एंड अदर ओरिजिनल डॉक्यूमेंट्स आल्सो न्यूज़पेपर रिपोर्ट्स बाय रिपोर्टर हु विटनेस एन इवेंट और हु कोट पीपल हु डिड स्पीचेस डायरीज लेटर्स एंड इंटरव्यूज what the people involved said or write. Then original research. Now we can see the method of data collection. जो हमें डेटा का कलेक्शन करना है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल हम कोई रिसर्च कर रहे या किसी पे हम कुछ डॉक्यूमेंट्री बना रहे हैं, ओके, सो इसके लिए हमें कुछ तो डेटा कलेक्शन करना पड़ता है, ओके, सो डेटा कलेक्शन के यहाँ पे दो पार्ट है, प्राइमरी सोर्सेज एंड द सेकेंडरी सोर्सेज. जो सेकेंडरी सोर्सेज है उसमें है डॉक्यूमेंट्स, ओके, द डॉक्यूमेंट कंसिस्ट a government publications, earlier researches, census, personal records, client histories, then service records. Okay. In primary sources, it include observation, interview, and questionnaires. In observation, we can see it include participant and non-participant. In interview consist structured and unstructured. It is a format of interview. And the last one is a questionnaire. It is a mail questionnaire or a collective questionnaire. Okay, so these are the method of a data collection.
Video audio mat on karo baba, pakde jayega.
Please mute your mic. Okay. Then the next topic is the primary sources can include various type of methods. जो primary sources है उसके जो various types है methods के वो हम यहाँ discuss करने वाले हैं. The first one is a experiment. Okay. The experiments required an artificial or a natural setting in which the perform logically study to collect data. Experiments are more suitable for medicinal, psychological studies, nutrition and for others, scientific studies. In experiment, the experimenter has to keep control over the influence of any extraneous variable on the results. Now the second is a survey. So what is survey? Survey is a most commonly used method in a social sciences, management, marketing, and psychology to some extent. Also survey can be conducted in different method. The next is a questionnaires. Okay. It is the most commonly used method in survey. Questionnaire are a list of question, either open-ended or a closed-ended. Okay, so what is an open-ended question and closed-ended question? Let's see in short. In open-ended question are the open for your own answer. Okay. इसमें आप अपना खुद का आंसर दे सकते हो, यस और नो, या फिर अदर इसके अलावा कोई आंसर हो तो. एंड द क्लोज एंडेड क्वेश्चंस में क्या होता है कि रिसर्चर्स प्रोवाइड सम ऑप्शंस टू यू. आपको यहाँ खुद का चयन करने के लिए कुछ चांस नहीं होता, रिसर्चर आपको प्रोवाइड करता है ऑप्शंस और उनमें से आपको एक चूज करना होता. फॉर एग्जाम्पल ओपन एंडेड क्वेश्चन का हम एक एग्जाम्पल लिखेंगे. फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर क्वेश्चन है हाउ डू यू गेट टू वर्क, ओके, ये क्वेश्चन है ओपन एंडेड क्वेश्चन का, तो इसका आंसर आप आपके हिसाब से दे सकते हो. बट इन क्लोज एंडेड क्वेश्चन में, क्वेश्चन टाइप में सेम क्वेश्चन क्या है, डू यू गेट अ वर्क बाय ड्राइविंग, बसिंग और वॉकिंग, तो इसमें आपका जो पर्सनल आंसर है वो आप नहीं बता सकते. इसमें जो ऑप्शन दिए हुए है वो ही आपको चूज करने होते हो. सो इट इज अ कंसेप्ट ऑफ अ ओपन एंडेड एंड अ क्लोज एंडेड क्वेश्चनरी. ओके, for which the respondent give answer. Questionnaires can be conducted via telephone, mail, or a live in public area, or in a institute through electronic mail or through a fax and other also methods. The next is the interview. The interview is a face-to-face conversation with the respondent. In interview, the main problem arises when the respondent deliberate hide information. Otherwise, it is an depth source of information. So, interview का एक drawback क्या है? अगर आप जिसका interview ले रहे हो और वो अगर कोई information आपसे छुपा रहा है, तो ये एक drawback इंटरव्यू का है. अदरवाइज ये बहुत ही अच्छा टूल है सर्वे का या फिर डेटा कलेक्शन का. ओके, द नेक्स्ट वन इज अ ऑब्जर्वेशन. ऑब्जर्वेशन कैन बी डन बाय लेटिंग द ऑब्जर्विंग पर्सन नो दैट शी और ही इज बीइंग ऑब्जर्व्ड और विदाउट लेटिंग हिम नो. ओके, ऑब्जर्वेशन कैन बी आल्सो बी मेड इन नेचुरल सेटिंग्स एज वेल एज इन artificial creative environment. Same problem observation tool में भी आ सकती है. अगर आप किसी को observation कर रहे हो किसी purpose के लिए, किसी research के लिए, और अगर उसको जिसका हम observation कर रहे हैं उसे अगर मालूम है कि मेरा observation, मेरा कोई तो observation कर रहा है किसी study के लिए, तो उसका जो nature होगा ना, तो वो natural नहीं होगा. तो इसमें कुछ तो artificial things आ सकती है. तो ये भी एक ड्रॉबैक ऑब्जर्वेशन इस टूल का हो सकता है. द नेक्स्ट वन इज द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ प्राइमरी डेटा. ओके, सो प्राइमरी डेटा का इंपॉर्टेंस क्या है? द फर्स्ट वन इज अ हेल्प इन स्टैटिस्टिकल सर्वे. So dear student, we can see the importance of primary data. So we can see in statistical survey, it is necessary to get information from primary sources and work on primary data. For example, the statistical records of female population in a country cannot be based on newspaper or magazine and the other printed sources. Okay, the next one is a reliable sources in a research. Then a researcher can be conducted without secondary data, but a research based on only secondary data is least reliable and may have bias because secondary data has already been manipulated by Bing. जो primary data है वो किसी ने handle किया हुआ नहीं होता है, इसके लिए वो एज इट इज आपके सामने आ सकता है. ओके, बट द सेकेंडरी डेटा क्या होता है कि वो प्रोसेस करके आता है, इसके लिए उसमें किसी का इम्पैक्ट भी आपको दिखाई दे सकता है. द लास्ट वन इज अ कंटेन लिमिटेड इंफॉर्मेशन. वन ऑफ सच सोर्स इज अ ओल्ड एंड सेकेंडरी. द कंटेन लिमिटेड इंफॉर्मेशन एज वेल एज दे कैन बी मिसेबल एंड बिसाइड्स. ओके, तो अब तक का आप सबको समझ में आया हुआ है या फिर कोई टॉपिक रिपीट करना है? यस और नो? सिंपली से यस और नो?
नो मैम.
ओके, देन द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज
नो मैम.
ओके ओके, थैंक यू फॉर रिस्पोंडिंग मी. The next topic is the advantages of using primary data. Okay, so what is the advantages of using primary data? The investigator collects data specific to the problem under study. Okay, the second is there is no doubt about the quality of the data collection for the investigator. The last one is a If required, it may be possible to obtain additional data during the study period. Okay. अगर अगर कोई सोचता है कि मुझे और कुछ ज्यादा इंफॉर्मेशन चाहिए तो वो प्राइमरी डेटा लेके वो अपने इंफॉर्मेशन और ज्यादा ले सकता है, उसमें कुछ तो ऐड कर सकता है अपने इंफॉर्मेशन में. द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज द डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ यूजिंग प्राइमरी डेटा. ओके, इससे पहले आप बता सकते हो कि प्राइमरी डेटा के यूजिंग प्राइमरी डेटा के एडवांटेजेस क्या है जो मैंने बताए, इसके अलावा कुछ होगा तो मुझे बताओ, जल्दी जल्दी आंसरिंग करो. और कुछ एडवांटेजेस हो सकते हैं? बस इतने ही एडवांटेजेस प्राइमरी डेटा के. ओके, देन कम टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ यूजिंग प्राइमरी डेटा. The investigator has to contend with all the hassles of data collection. The next one is deciding why, what, how, when to collect. Okay. Next is getting the data collected personally or through others. Getting funding and dealing with funding agencies. ये किसका बहुत बड़ा डिसएडवांटेजेस है. ओके, द लास्ट वन इज इथिकल कंसिडरेशन, दैट इज कंसर्न प्रीमाइसेस एक्सेट्रा. सो दीज आर द एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ द प्राइमरी डेटा. ओके, नाउ द नेक्स्ट point is secondary data. Abhi humne primary data source pura explain kiya. Primary data source kya hai, uski concept kya hai, then what is the advantages, disadvantages, type, ye sab humne isme describe kiya. To next lecture mein we can see the we will see the secondary data sources. Okay. Now we shall stop here. If you have any queries, then ask me. Okay. Do you have any queries or question? No. Okay, then we shall stop here. Meet again our next lecture. Okay, bye, take care.
Okay, bye ma'am.